Today you'll be learning how to edit song details on Windows, and this basically makes sure that the song properties are all correct so that you can import them into Spotify or any sort of other music player. Hey, what's up guys, it's Josh or Fusion here, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to edit your song details on Windows. Now this works exactly the same on Windows 10 and 11. Make sure you guys subscribe to Fusion here for more videos that make tech easier. Basically, I already set all the song details in here, so whenever I open one of these songs with Groove Music, which is like Windows Music Player, it has the album art, it has the title, and it also has the artist name. Now, making sure all the details on our songs are correct are very important for making organization on your computer or for making sure that the song shows up correctly on your music player. If you don't have the correct details on one of your songs, as you can see in Spotify, it shows up weird. It shows up without an album art, or like this one right here, it doesn't even say yeet, and it still has unreleased in brackets in the title. So now to edit the song details of a single song, all you want to do is right click on the MP3, head down to show more options, and then go to properties. Now that we're in properties, you can see that at the bottom it says this file came from another computer and might be blocked to help protect this computer. You want to make sure that you select unblock. Sometimes when Windows automatically blocks these MP3s, this can actually be a reason that Spotify isn't recognizing or playing the song. Now that you unblocked the MP3, you want to hit apply in the bottom right. But we're not done yet. You want to head over to the details tab, and as you can see, this song is completely blank. When there's no data in here, Windows just tries to do its best to find whatever it can and fill in certain things. What can then happen is on Spotify, it looks all messed up and our songs look all blank and weird. So you just want to find the information for your song and enter it in these columns. Title: this song's name is Poppin'. Contributing artists would be Yeet. And it will pop up previous artists in here that you have selected before. You want to make sure you put in the album artist as the same contributing artists. And then for the album name, this is going to be grouping your songs together. So this album is called Two Alive, so I'm going to paste that in there, and now we're good. These are the only details that we need on our songs: the name, the artist, and the album that it's from. You don't want to put in the year, the number of the track, the genre, or anything else. This can actually mess up the song and make it unplayable inside of Spotify. So now that we have the title, the contributing artist, the album artist, and the album entered in here, you want to hit apply on the song. Now we can just hit OK and exit out of here. Now if I open up this song inside of Groove Music, it's gonna say the correct song title, Poppin', from Yeet onto Alive. This is exactly how we want it to look. You can actually edit multiple song details at one time. This would be useful if you're trying to edit like 12 songs for an entire album and have them all have the metadata to correspond to that album. By the way, if this video is helping you guys, drop a like on it and subscribe to Fusion here. It helps out a lot. All you guys want to do to update all of these songs at once is first click on song 1, and then hold down shift and click on the last song in the album. It will highlight every single song in the album, and from here you just want to right click. Now you want to click on show more options. Then you want to head to properties, and it looks a little different this time, but you want to head over to details. Now we don't want to be touching the title tab, because this would be updating the title on every single song, and that would mess up our organization. What we do want to be editing is the album. Right here, if I typed in something different like Fusion here and just applied it for this video, it's applying properties to all 20 items, and now if I open one of these songs in Windows Media Player, the album is Fusion here. Now there's a chance your album art still wouldn't be showing up at this point. To fix the album art for our MP3s, we need to do it inside of the Windows Media Player. So that's what I'm in right now. It used to be called Groove Music, so I call it that sometimes. Basically, you just want to right click on your album art that's not showing, and you want to click on Show Album. It will then take you to the corresponding album that your song is tied to, and you can actually edit the album art picture inside of this screen. All you want to do is head up to See More, and then click on this little pencil that says Edit Info. Now once you're inside of here, there's another pencil right here that says Change Album Art. You can click on this, select any PNG or JPEG that's big enough, and it will update the album art for your song. And now that we got all the correct details on our song, I'm going to show you guys that I could add it to Spotify and it would look completely totally normal. So now that I'm on Spotify, I'm gonna head up to my preferences. You wanna scroll down in your settings and you wanna make sure that show local files is turned on. Now that you've done that, you wanna head over to your library and head into your local files. I have a more detailed video on how to set up your computer to upload songs to Spotify files. If you wanna watch that, the card will be in the top right. And now if we search Poppin inside of our local files, it comes right up, Poppin by Yeet. I can play it, I could add it to a playlist, whatever I would like to. So anyways guys, this has been how to edit your song details on Windows to make sure that your songs have the right metadata and show up inside of your music players. I hope this video helped you guys. If you guys want more videos that make tech easier to understand and show you how to do things online, make sure you guys drop a like on this video and subscribe to Fusion here, and I'll see you guys in the next one.